I give an honor to God. I give an honor to my pastor and to the first lady in her absence on today. I just truly thank God that God has allowed me to come forth with the word of God with excitement to give you guys the good news of Jesus. On today, the topic is you just got to want more. So on today, the topic says that you just got to want more. To understand that to want more, there comes a word called perseverance to want more. To want more means leaving, letting go of those things that are behind you and pressing toward the mark. Amen? As we go to Philippians 4 and 8, I would like to let you know that Philippians 4 and 8 is the 6 exhortations that Paul was given for us as Christians to apply in our lives so that we might experience the peace of God. And understand that the peace of God comes when we as Christians think and meditate on all the things that are of God. Amen. So understand that sometimes we act accordingly to the way we think. And we must understand that the way we think is the way we're going to act in spirit. So if we are thinking of these things that are not of God, then we begin to operate in the spirit of being carnal. And then from carnal, it becomes death. Amen. And then to be carnal is death, to understand that then we open up the door for the enemy to come in. And as the enemy comes in, then we give place to the enemy and allow the enemy to come in. And we're not able to do the things God has called us to do. And we allow the carnal mind to stop us from being in the peace of God. Go with me to Philippians 4 and 8. The word of God says, finally, my brethren, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are of good report, if there be any virtue, and if there be any praise, think on these things. So I want you guys to understand that it's a reason why Paul is giving this exhortation of good words, of encouragement for us to think on these things, because our mind tend to get into carnal stages and allow the enemy to come in. And the only way we can stay connected and focused with full force is keeping our minds on Jesus. And the word true, John 14 and 6, I am the way, the truth, and the life. So understand that we got to think on things that are true. Keep our minds on things that are true. Believe the good report of Jesus. Think on those things that are true, not the things that the devil tried to bring to us. And I would like to ask you, why are we believing the lies from the enemy when he is not the truth? The devil is not the truth. Why do we accept everything from the enemy? Everything the enemy brings us, we accept it sometimes. We can't accept everything the enemy brings us. Nothing the enemy brings us. Amen? Think on the things that are right when in your thoughts. I'm sorry. Think on the things that are right. Let your thoughts in your lives, be centered upon the things that God wants you to think on that brings on the spirit of peace. Amen? Amen. And understand that our thoughts and our lives are centered upon true things. Peace comes to our heart. Amen? When we center our thoughts upon things that are true. And as we go to honest and we speak about the things that are honest, we understand that we need to think on things that are honest. God is eternal life. That is honest. Amen? Amen. Thinking on his promise, those things are honest. Even being honest to others. If we think on these things, we wouldn't have to deal with the distractions of the enemy, because our minds are set to think on things that are honest of God. Amen? Think on these things. Amen? And as we go to just, justice to be right, to be fair, and to fear the Lord, not manipulating people because we can and we know we wrong. Amen? There is no peace in that. To be justice, to be fair, upright with God. before God. Be fair at everything we do before God, because we got to always think on these things, because the enemy is always present seeking who he may devour. Amen? Here, as we go to Peter, Matthew 5 and 8 says, blessed are the pure in heart. Being pure is making peace. Amen? Meditating on how to keep our heart pure before God. And repenting daily, thinking on these things that will be right before God. Being pure is avoiding foolish and ignorant disputes that will turn into strife. And being pure comes with not bickering and fighting among your sisters and your brothers, but loving and having humility and being gentle one toward another. Amen? And as we go to lovely, you know, God tells us to think on whatsoever things are lovely. We shouldn't have the thoughts of unkindness and meanness, grumbling and murmuring. Our thoughts should focus on things that are lovely, that build up people, not tear them down. We as Christians must think on these things that are lovely, not stir up others to anger and hate. Remember, these things will bring peace and healing to the mind. We are to think on the things that are lovely. I just want you to focus on why God wants us, why Paul gave them exhortation words for us to be lifted up in the body of Christ. That we just must really focus on the positive things in God, the Word of God, everything God gave to us, everything God told us in His Word. We must focus on these things because the enemy is always present. Amen. As we go to the good report, you know, we need to be able to bring a good report. And that good report is God's promise. That good report is great things that Jesus is going to do. That good report is knowing that Jesus loves, Jesus heals. Bring the good news. So when the enemy tries to come and alter your mind, just begin to think on the good things God has in store for us. Bring the good news to somebody else that will relieve the foolishness and stop the enemy at his coming. Amen? So as we go to... thank you, Jesus. Understand that as we keep our focus on God, this will begin to push out gossip, evil thinking, things that are not of God, and even judging when we keep our mind on God. Amen? As we go to virtue, there is a standard of excellence in the six exhortations that carries meaning to our salvation that is worthy and worth giving God praise for. So all six of these exhortations, it should be a meaning to it. It should have virtue. It should be that the Word of God should make you want to value what the Word of God is saying to make you move forward in God. Let it be virtue. And when it becomes meaningful to you, when you begin to apply these things to your life, then there comes a praise. Amen. Then there will God get the glory out of your life. If there be any praise, in other words, if there be any praise, if you do such these things, then a praise will come out of it. If we keep our focus on Jesus, if we meditate on Him day and night, we can have the peace of God in our lives. If we have the mindset to keep our minds on Him and want more of what His words say, amen? Don't allow the devil to come and tear you down. Don't let him tear down your spirit. Don't let him come in with the distractions. Don't let him bring in the spirit of depression. Don't allow him to bring in the spirit of anxiety. Don't even allow him to cause you to want to throw in the towel. Because we have to keep our focus on these things. Uplifting one another, walking in the spirit, living in the spirit. And he said, I will keep your, I'm sorry, he said, let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. So we don't have to be subject to Satan's devices if we let this mind be in us, which is also in Christ Jesus.